Britain, France, and Germany are adding their names to the list of countries grounding Boeing 737 from taking to the sky. It's the same type of plane that crashed Sunday in Ethiopia, killing everyone on board. And we're learning more about those who died, including a number of Catholics. Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reports from the State Department. Good evening, Wyatt.
Good evening, Lauren. Family members of those victims are demanding to know exactly what happened to the jetliner, which crashed just 6 minutes after takeoff. Many flyers are now skeptical about boarding a Boeing 737 MAX 8, but the United States has yet to ground those planes. The FAA says it's hoping to learn more as part of Ethiopia's ongoing investigation.
American aviation and Israeli forensic experts are on site at the crash scene of the Ethiopian Airlines flight 302, trying to figure out why the plane crashed. The area is now part of a global investigation. The jetliner went down Sunday, just minutes after taking off from Ethiopia's capital. It's a regular flight, bringing missionaries, aid workers, and diplomats to Kenya's capital. All 157 people on board were killed. This man says he saw the plane coming down. It rotated two times in the air and had smoke coming from the back. Then it hit the ground and exploded. Among the rubble, investigators are finding personal items, including pictures of loved ones. Ethiopian pilots and flight crew offered prayers during a vigil for the staff members who died. In Northern California, Catholics are also mourning the loss of two brothers. Melvin and Bennett Riffle attended St. Joseph's Catholic School in Redding, California. Their family says they appreciate the outpouring of love and prayers. In addition, two Kenyan natives, a sister and a priest, were on board. Both served as Catholic missionaries. Catholic Relief Services lost four staff members who worked to provide food to the starving. And finally, a Georgetown law student who served as an on-campus chaplain. The Federal Aviation Administration now says it will order Boeing to modify its 737 MAX 8 jets. The FAA notes a similar crash in Indonesia just 5 months ago. Aviation experts say there are no signs terrorism is to blame.
It's never one thing. It's always a multiple combination of factors that lead to a catastrophic accident like this. And so that is what we can expect, multiple factors.
Some lawmakers are urging the FAA to go the same way as European countries are and ground the Boeing 737 MAX 8 just as a precaution. Several airlines, like American and Southwest, who use the same type of plane regularly, say they are confident with their equipment and their staff, which have not reported the same kind of problem. Lauren.
Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reporting from the State Department. Thank you, Wyatt.